The Medal of Honor is the highest award given to military servicemen and women of the United States for valor in action. Out of the 3,500 Medal of Honor recipients, only 69 are still living. The 25th of March marks the National Medal of Honor Day. Please join me in honoring and celebrating these brave servicemen and women who have made great sacrifices to protect our freedoms.
The Medal of Honor, a history of the award and highlights of Worcester's recipients. The Medal of Honor is the highest and most prestigious personal military decoration. The Congressional Medal of Honor is not the proper name. There are three versions of the medal, one for the Army, Navy, and Air Force. The first formal system for rewarding acts of individual gallantry was established by General George Washington on August 7, 1782, for any singularly meritorious action. The award was a cloth Purple Heart. The badge of military merit fell into oblivion until 1932, when General Douglas MacArthur pressed for its revival. Officially reinstituted on February 22, 1932, the now familiar Purple Heart was at first an Army award, given to those who had been wounded in World War I or who possessed a meritorious service citation certificate. In 1943, the order was amended to include the personnel of the Navy, Marine Corps, and Coast Guard. Coverage was eventually extended to include all services and any civilian national wounded while serving with the armed forces. Although the badge of military merit fell into disuse after the Revolutionary War, the idea of a decoration for individual gallantry remained through the early 1800s. In 1847, after the outbreak of the Mexican-American War, a certificate of merit was established for any soldier who distinguished himself in action. No medal went with the honor. After the Mexican-American War, the award was discontinued, which meant there was no military award with which to recognize the nation's fighting men. Early in the Civil War, a medal for individual valor was proposed to the General-in-Chief of the Army, Winfield Scott, but Scott felt medals smacked of European affectation and killed the idea. The medal found support in the Navy, however, where it was felt recognition of courage and strife was needed. Public Resolution 82, containing a provision for a Navy Medal of Valor, was signed into law by President Abraham Lincoln on December 21, 1861. The medal was to be bestowed upon such petty officers, seamen, landsmen, and marines as shall most distinguish themselves by their gallantry and other seamanlike qualities during the present war. Shortly after this, a resolution similar in wording was introduced on behalf of the Army. Signed into law July 12, 1862, the measure provided for awarding a Medal of Honor to such non-commissioned officers and privates as shall most distinguish themselves by their gallantry in action and other soldier-like qualities during the present insurrection. Although it was created for the Civil War, Congress made the Medal of Honor a permanent decoration in 1863. Almost 3,400 men and one woman have received the award for heroic actions in the nation's battles since that time. The Medal of Honor is awarded by the President of the United States in the name of Congress to a person who, while a member of the Army, Navy, or Air Force, distinguishes himself or herself conspicuously by gallantry and intrepidity at the risk of his or her life above and beyond the call of duty while engaged in an action against an enemy of the United States, while engaged in military operations involving conflict with an opposing foreign force, or while serving with friendly foreign forces engaged in an armed conflict against an opposing armed force in which the United States is not a belligerent party. The criteria for receiving the award differs between the branches of the armed forces. In the Army, the deed performed must have been one of personal bravery or self-sacrifice so conspicuous as to clearly distinguish the individual above his or her comrades, and must have involved risk of life. Incontestable proof of the performance of the service will be exacted, and each recommendation for the award of this decoration will be considered on the standard of extraordinary merit. In the Navy, there must be no margin of doubt or possibility of error in awarding this honor. To justify the decoration, the individual's service must clearly be rendered conspicuous above his or her comrades by an act so outstanding that it clearly distinguishes his or her gallantry beyond the call of duty from lesser forms of bravery, and it must be the type of deed which, if not done, would not subject the individual to any justified criticism. The deed must be without detriment to the mission of the command or to the command to which attached. In the Air Force, the deed performed must have been one of personal bravery or self-sacrifice, so conspicuous as to clearly distinguish the service member above his or her comrades, and must have involved risk of life. Proof beyond a reasonable doubt that the service member performed the valorous action for which they were recommended for the Medal of Honor. To this day, only one member of the Coast Guard has received the award, Douglas Monroe. Mary Walker was the only woman awarded the Medal of Honor at Bull Run on July 21, 1861. William Kearny was the first African-American recipient. He was awarded the Medal of Honor for his actions on July 18, 1863, in Fort Wagner, South Carolina. The recipients from Worcester were John Coleman, George W. Matthews, John Michalowski, Reverend Joseph T. O'Callaghan, Thomas Plunkett, Charles H. Pinkham, John Vincent Power, and David Roche. John Coleman was a private in the U.S. Marine Corps, born on the 9th of October, 1847 in Ireland. His citation reads, "On board the USS Colorado in action at Korea on 11 June 1871. Fighting hand-to-hand with the enemy, Coleman succeeded in saving the life of Alexander Mackenzie." George W. Matthews was an assistant surgeon with the U.S. Army's 36th Infantry Division and was born in Worcester, Massachusetts. He received the Medal of Honor for his actions near Labo, Luzon in the Philippines on October 29, 1899. His citation reads, "While in attendance upon the wounded and under severe fire from the enemy, he seized a carbine and beat off an attack upon wounded officers and men under his charge." John Michalowski was a torpedoman first class with the U.S. Navy. He was born August 12, 1910 in Worcester. His citation reads, "For extraordinary heroism in the line of his profession during the rescue and salvage operations following the sinking of the USS Squalus on May 23, 1939. Michalowski, as a member of the rescue chamber crew, made the last extremely hazardous trip of the rescue chamber to attempt the rescue of any possible survivors in the flooded after portion of the Squalus. He was fully aware of the great danger involved in that, if he and the other member of the crew became incapacitated, there was no way in which either could be rescued. During the salvage operations, Michalowski made important and difficult dives under the most hazardous conditions. His outstanding performance of duty contributed much to the success of the operations and characterized his conduct far above and beyond the ordinary call of duty." Reverend Joseph T. O'Callaghan, who held the rank of commander in the U.S. Navy, was born May 14, 1904 in Boston. He received his Medal of Honor for actions near Kobe, Japan on March 19, 1945. His citation reads, "For conspicuous gallantry and intrepidity at the risk of his life above and beyond the call of duty while serving as chaplain on board the USS Franklin, when that vessel was fiercely attacked by enemy Japanese aircraft during offensive operations near Kobe, Japan on March 19, 1945. A valiant and forceful leader, calmly braving the perilous barriers of flame and twisted metal to aid his men and his ship, Lieutenant Commander O'Callaghan groped his way through smoke-filled corridors to the open flight deck and into the midst of violently exploding bombs, shells, rockets, and other armament. With the ship rocked by incessant explosions, with debris and fragments raining down and fires raging in ever-increasing fury, he ministered to the wounded and dying, comforting and encouraging men of all faiths. He organized and led firefighting crews into the blazing inferno on the flight deck. He directed the jettisoning of live ammunition and the flooding of the magazine. He manned a hose to cool hot armed bombs rolling dangerously on the listing deck, continuing his efforts despite searing, suffocating smoke, which forced men to fall back gasping and imperiled others who replaced them. Serving with courage, fortitude, and deep spiritual strength, Lieutenant Commander O'Callaghan inspired the gallant officers and men of the Franklin to fight heroically and with profound faith in the face of almost certain death, and to return their stricken ship to port." Thomas Plunkett was born in Ireland, but entered service in West Boylston, Massachusetts, eventually rising to the rank of sergeant in the 21st Massachusetts Infantry Division. He received his Medal of Honor for actions taken at Fredericksburg, Virginia, on December 11, 1862. His citation reads, "That he seized the colors of his regiment, the color bearer having been shot down, and bore them to the front, where both his arms were carried off by a shell." Charles H. Pinkham, born in Grafton, was a sergeant major in the 57th Massachusetts Infantry Division. He received his Medal of Honor for actions at Fort Stedman, Virginia on March 25, 1865. His citation reads that he captured the flag of the 57th North Carolina Infantry and saved his own colors by tearing them from the staff while the enemy was in the camp. John Vincent Power, born November 20, 1918 in Worcester, was a first lieutenant in the U.S. Marine Corps. His citation reads, "For conspicuous gallantry and intrepidity at the risk of his life above and beyond the call of duty as platoon leader attached to the 4th Marine Division during the landing and battle of Namur Island, Kwajalein Atoll in the Marshall Islands on February 1, 1944. Severely wounded in the stomach while setting a demolition charge on a Japanese pillbox, First Lieutenant Power was steadfast in his determination to remain in action. Protecting his wound with his left hand and firing with his right, he courageously advanced as another hostile position was taken under attack, fiercely charging the opening made by the explosion and emptying his carbine into the pillbox. While attempting to reload and continue the attack, First Lieutenant Power was shot again in the stomach and head and collapsed in the doorway. His exceptional valor, fortitude, and indomitable fighting spirit in the face of withering enemy fire were in keeping with the highest traditions of the U.S. Naval Service. He gallantly gave his life for his country. David Roach, born in Ireland, was a first sergeant in the 5th U.S. Infantry Division. He received his Medal of Honor for actions at Cedar Creek, Montana, between the 21st of October 1876 and January 8, 1877. His citation is for gallantry in action.